Hello friends, welcome to GMG Accountancy Classes. Today we are going to discuss about 11th Standard Accountancy Ledger Sum. So this is a very easy illustration and important illustration so that you can understand how to prepare the ledger. Illustration 5. Tamiz and Bun started book selling business on 1st January 2018. So on 1st January 2018, he started the business. Following are the transactions took place in the business for the month of January 2018. Pass journal entries and prepare ledger account. So you have to prepare both journal entry and ledger account. Now see the first one. 2018 Jan 1, started business with cash, rupees 3 lakh. So what is the first journal entry? Cash account data to the name of the person, Tamiz and Bun's capital account. So whatever the name is given, you have to write here. Then open a bank account by depositing. When you open a bank account, you deposit the money into the bank. So cash goes out. So already I discussed how to prepare the journal entry. In the journal entry sums. Now open a bank account by depositing rupees 2 lakhs. When you deposit the money, cash goes out. Bank will be debited. So bank account data to cash account. Now see here, the answer is bank account data to cash account rupees 2 lakhs. Understand? Now see the fifth one. Goods bought from Tamil Nadu Textbook Corporation for cash. You purchase the book for cash. What comes in? Books comes. What goes out? Cash goes out. So purchase account data to cash account. So whatever goes out will be credited. So cash goes out because cash is the real account and money goes out. So it is credited. Purchase the normal account, so debit the expenses, so it is debited. Next, sold goods to MM traders for cash. When you're selling something, what comes in? Cash goods. So cash is debited. Cash is the real account. Debit what comes in. And sold, sales. Sales is the nominal account. What is the rules for nominal account? Debit all expenses and losses. Credit all income and gain. So when we are selling, it is the income for us. So it is catered. So what is the entry? Cash account data to sales account. So you see here, cash account data to sales account. Now see the date 22. Purchase goods from Mexican company for rupees 15,000. You purchase goods from Mexican company for how much? 15,000. And the payment is made through net banking. How you made the payment? Through net banking. So through net banking you make the payment. So what comes in goods? It has been not mentioned, it is furniture or computer, whatever you need. So you have to write only purchase. How you make the payment? Through bank. So bank, from money goes out from the bank. So bank is created. So purchase account data to bank account. See, purchase account data to bank account, 15,000. Next one, sold goods to YN company. You sold goods to YN company for rupees 30,000. And the payment is received through NEFT. NEFT means banking, through bank transaction it has been came. So the money back came in the bank. So wherever the money comes, it has been debited. So bank is debited. You sold, so sales is created. So bank account data to sales account. Understand? So now you understand the journal entries. Now I'll say how to prepare the ledger account. You have to take two papers, take out, open your ledger notebook, open a double new page. Now see here how to write the heading. In the center of your book, left hand side of your book, in the center, write it cash, and right side you have to write account in the center of your page. Above date column you write the account, and left hand side above credit column you write cash. This is the heading. Then here you write debit, here you have to write credit. Okay, then date, particulars, LF column you have to write GF, and outer column you have to write rupees. Same way, date, particulars, GF, outer column rupees. Now see the first entry. For cash account only, you have to leave 10 lines for cash account, writing the heading in one page. If once you write the heading, that is enough. Next page, once again, if you write, you write once again the headings. So date, particulars, JF, rupees or amount, any one thing you can write here. Now for cash account only, you have to leave 10 lines. For other all account, whether it is a capital account or sales account or any other name, you have to leave 6 lines, that is more than enough. Now see the first journal entry. Cash account data to capital account, right? Cash account data to capital account is written. Cash account data to Tami Zanban's capital account, right? So see it. This is cash account. Already we opened, leave 10 lines. Then we open the capital account. Now see here, in always, this is debit side. 2 means debit side and buy means credit side. So in cash account, you have to write 2, that is in capital account. Same way, in capital account, you write buy cash account, opposite side. Understand? Now see the second entry. Bank account data to cash account. Bank account data to cash account. So when you are writing bank account data to cash account, so in bank, see here, in bank account you have to write to cash account January 2 to cash account 2 lakhs, and then opposite year 2 return, so opposite is buy. So in cash account you have to write buy bank account. Understand? Next, date 5, purchase account data to cash account. So in purchase you write to cash, in cash you write buy purchase. See here, in cash account you return buy purchase. In this purchase account, see, you open once again purchase account. In purchase account you write to bank account, right? So already if it has been opened, purchase account, no need to open once again. If it has been not open, you have to open the purchase account. Next one, date 15, cash account data to sales account. Cash is already opened. Now we have to open the sales account. So in cash we have to write 2 sales. See here, in cash we have to write 2 sales. Date 15, 2 sales. In sales we have to write buy cash. See here, in sales account we have to write buy cash account 5000, right? Understand? Next, after date 15 is date 22, purchase account data to bank account. So in purchase you will write to bank, and in bank you will write buy purchase. Once again I repeat, in purchase account you have to write to bank, and in bank account you have to write buy purchase. Same way, in bank account you have to write to sales, in sales account you have to write buy bank. See here, day 25, in bank account you have to write to sales, in bank account you have to write to sales. And see the sales account, the last ledger, in sales account you have to write buy bank account. Understand? So now the posting is over. Now how to close the account? Now come to the cash account. Cash account is the real account. And always remember, all the assets have all the assets and expenses. Once again, I repeat, listen it very carefully and note it down. All the assets and expenses always debit balance, means all the assets and expenses, debit side amount will be more. So see here, this is the cash account, means asset account. Why we are writing asset account? Because cash will come under assets. So 3 lakh plus 5,000, 3 lakh 5,000. Okay, here you have to write 31st by balance carry down, then leave one line, put the total line in both the side in the same line, then 3 lakh 5,000 minus 2 lakh 10,000 will get 95,000. Once again I repeat, 3 lakh 5,000 minus 2 lakh 10,000, 95,000, means you have to add both this and minus from 3 lakh 5,000 will get 95,000. So this month carry down, next month brought down. Below the total line, will write two balance brought down, 95,000. Now see the capital account. In capital account, credit side 3 lakh is given, debit side nothing is given. So 3 lakhs, same total you write 3 lakhs. Nothing is given, means you write two balance carry down. So wherever the amount is less, you have to write carry down. This is the January month, so January ending date is 31st. So 31st January 2018. This side carry on means opposite side brought down. So February 1 by balance brought down 3 lakhs. Same way, bank account. Bank is the assets, so the good side always more. 2 lakh 30,000, 2 lakh plus 30,000. This side is less. So write it January 31st by balance carry down. Then put the total into total. You write this 2 lakh 30,000 both the side. 2 lakh 30,000 minus 15,000 will get 2 lakh 15,000. So this month closing balance, next month opening balance. Opening balance we have to write below the total. February 1, 2 balance brought down. Understand? Now see the purchase account. This side is 25,000 and this side is nothing is given. So we have to write by balance carry down. January 31, 25,000. This month carry down, next month brought down. So below the total, 25,000. Now last ledger, sales account. In the sales account, credit side by cash account and by bank account, 5,000 plus 30,000, 34,000. And this side, debit side, nothing is given. So if nothing is given, you would like to balance trade off. 35,000 minus 0, 35,000. So this month carried on, next month brought down. Understand? Very good boys. Now we move on to illustration 6. Bharti is a sole trader dealing in oil products for the past 5 years. The books of account showed the following balances on 1st April 2018. Cash in hand 25,000. Cash at bank 3 lakhs. The following transaction took place for the month of April 2018. What do you mean of this? Bharti is a sole trader dealing in the oil products from past 5 years. His cash balance is 25,000 and his bank balance is 3 lakhs. Understand? Now, he given the transaction for the April month. Pass the entries and prepare the ledger. Now, see the first journal entry. Goods bought by giving a check. Bought means what? Purchase. When you purchase, what comes in? Goods comes in. So goods bought by giving a check. When you make a payment through check, the money goes out from the bank. So purchase account data to bank account. Wherever from the money goes out, it has been created. Or as per the golden rules, there are two accounts. One is purchase, one is bank. Purchase is which account? Personal account, real account or nominal account? Purchase is the nominal account. So what is the rule for purchase account, nominal account? Debit all expenses and losses, create all income and gain. So when we purchase, it is an expense or income? It is an expense. So it has been debited. So debit all expenses and losses because we purchased it. Now bank. Bank is what? It's our property. So it is a real account. So what is the rule for real account? Debit what comes in, take what goes out. So from where the money goes out? From the bank. So it is credited. Well, in simple way, from wherever the money goes out, it has been credited. So now bank, from our bank the money goes out, so bank is credited. And goods comes in, so it is debited. So simple way, whatever comes in, debit it. Whatever goes out, credit it. Okay. Next one, goods sold to Naveen and payment received through NEFT. What you done? You sold the goods. So sales, you done the sales. Sales is the credit balance. Okay. Now, from where you got the money? Through NEFT. So where the money comes in your hand? No. It comes in your bank. So bank is debited. So bank account data to sales account. See here. Bank account data to sales account 40,000. Next, goods sold to Xavier for cash. So now you have sold goods for cash. So what comes in? Cash comes in. So it is debited, cash account data. What goes out? Goods goes out. Then is sales. So sales is debited. So cash account data to sales account date 6. Cash account data to sales account 20,000. Now goods sold on credit to Abdul for 25,000. When you sold goods to Akbar, Abdul, so name comes. Whenever name comes, it is a credit sales. Sold means sales, so it is credit sales. So whenever credit sales, simple thing you have to remember, credit sales means name will be debited. So answer is Abdul account data to sales account. See here, Abdul account data to sales account. Next one, cash received from Abdul. What comes in? Cash comes in. From where the money goes out? From the Abdul. Or you can say in your golden rules if you want. Cash is the real account. Debit what comes in. So just debit it. And Abdul is what? Personal account. Because name comes. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So because Abdul is the giver, so it is credited. Or in simple way, whatever comes in debited, from wherever it is goes out, it is credited. So cash comes in because we receive, so cash is debited. And Abdul is the making payment, so Abdul is credited. So cash account data to Abdul account. See here, cash account data to Abdul account. Now in this sum, everything is same like the previous sum for preparing a ledger. Now only this one thing you have to remember very carefully. See here, opening balance is given 1st April 2018. Cash balance is 25,000 and bank balance is 3 lakhs. So whenever opening balance is given means two balance brought down. Opening balance means brought down. Opening balance means brought down because both are assets. So this is debit balance. So it is brought down. So in cash, 25,000 two balance brought down. In bank, 3 lakhs two balance brought down. See here, first you have to open in a new page, double page, cash account. two lines brought down to 25,000. Then below that, leave 10 lines and prepare the bank account. Two balance brought down, 3 lakhs. Understand? So, whenever opening balance given, it write brought down. Then come to the normal sum, normal generator. In purchase, it write to bank account. In bank, we write buy purchase. Same way in bank, two sales. In sales, buy bank. In cash, two sales account. In sales, buy cash account. In Abdul account, they write two sales. In sales, they write buy Abdul account. So the last entry, in cash, two Abdul. See here, in cash, return two Abdul. In Abdul, they write buy cash. See the Abdul account, they write buy cash account. Now, same way, in the like previous sum, we have to put the total amount. We have to add the debit side, 55,000. Credit side is nothing, so buy balance carried out 55,000. So this month carried out, next month brought down. Likewise, all the ledger we have to prepare. Here also 3,40,000, 3 lakh plus 40,000, 3,40,000. Minus purchase amount, you will get the amount 3 lakhs. So, then 3 lakhs you have to write here. So, likewise, you have to prepare all the ledger. Now, see the illustration 7. Till illustration 6, we are preparing the journal entry, then we are preparing the ledger. In this sum, you have to prepare direct ledger. This is very important, sir. You have to prepare direct ledger. So direct ledger means without journal entry, you have to prepare the ledger, direct ledger posting. See the illustration 7. It has been clearly mentioned, prepare cash account. So you have to prepare only cash account, nothing else. Prepare cash account from the following transaction for the month of January 2018. Commence business with cash. So what is the journal entry normally? Commence business with cash. Cash account data to capital. So in cash, to capital account. Capital account no need to prepare, so no need to write. If we prepare, we return in capital account by cash. Goods purchased for cash. So what is the generality? Goods purchased for cash. Purchase account data to cash account. So in purchase account to cash. So in cash account, what we have to write? By purchase account. Goods sold for cash. So what is the journal entry for goods sold for cash? Cash account data to sales account. So in cash, you have to write two sales. So in cash account, you have to write two sales account. Two means debit side you have to write. Okay. Then wages paid. Wages paid means payment, money goes out. So wages account data to cash account. So in wages account, you write to cash. In cash account, what you write by wages account. Furniture purchased for cash. So what comes in? Furniture comes in. What is furniture? It is an assets. It is in real account. What's the rule for real account? Debit what comes in, paid what goes out. So furniture is debited because it comes in. Cash is also a real account. What is the rule for real account? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash goes out. So what is the general entry? Furniture account data to cash account, because furniture comes in and cash goes out. So in furniture account, you write to cash. In cash, what you have to write? By furniture account. Then write 31st by balance carried out, because debit side total is more. 62,000 plus 10,000, 72,000. 72,000 minus all this amount, you will get 50,000. So this month carry down will be the next month brought down. Understand? Very good, boss. Now you understand the ledger. Now you practice the exercise sums.